And so that was the discovery of lysosomes, which I've tried to explain. And the paper was published in August 1955 in the Biochemical Journal by de Duve, Pressman, Gianetto, Appelmans, and Wattiaux. Now, this is one of the only papers in which I put my name first, because most of the papers published from my group, I always put my name at the end and gave first authorship to the students or the co-workers who'd done the most important work. But in this paper, I remember clearly discussing with my colleague, and I said, well, I think I have to take responsibility, because this is putting ourselves on a limb, and I think I want to. Frankly, I think I'm being honest in saying that. I wasn't trying to take the credit. I just want to say, well, this is a risky thing. This is a thing that I am responsible for, and so I put my name first. That was the lysosome, and just a word about the uricase. In the original paper, we said either uricase is in the membrane of the lysosome, which explains why it is not latent and does not have an acid pH optimum. Because, I forgot to mention this, of course, the digestive particles were supposed to act to have an acid inside, because all those enzymes required acid, so they were like the cell's stomach. They had an acid juice inside, the digestive juice inside. Well, anyway, so with it, either uricase belongs to the membrane, or it belongs to yet another particle that has similar sedimentation properties, so it cannot be separated from the lysosomes by sedimentation. Well, I think I will come back to that later, because that was, of course, the major second discovery that we made. But in the meantime, a little more should be said about the lysosomes.